What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So Genshin Impact's been working for a little bit now on the Steam Deck through its native launcher, which is awesome to see, and game performance is actually pretty good as well. So I finally got some time to go ahead and make a guide and check this out for myself and see how it's working. Now, we do need to do everything in desktop mode to start with, so if you're in game mode, you're going to want to jump over and change into desktop mode. Now, once you do that, you're going to want to use whatever your favorite browser may be to go over to the Genshin website and download the installer. So I'm just going to click on the PC download option that I have here right in front of me, and that's going to download it on Firefox. Now, if you get stopped here and you have pop-ups blocked, you might need to click preferences and allow that, which will then kick in the download for you. So if you don't see the download kick off, look for that up there in the bar and see if you need to change that. Now, once you have that downloaded, we're going to want to add it to Steam so we can install it. Now, there's different ways of doing that. If you remember right, we can do an add a non-Steam game from Steam, or we can go right here into our downloads folder where I just downloaded that. I'm just going to right click, come down here and click add to Steam. It does the same thing as the other method of going in and adding a non-Steam game. Now, once that's finished, we'll be able to go find that in Steam. So we'll close this out. I'm going to go ahead and open up Steam here. And then once I go into my library, I want to scroll down till I find that Genshin install file we just added, and here it is right here. All right, now for those of you that want to see the old school method alternatively to add this to Steam, I'm just going to show it real quick. If you don't care about this, just go ahead and speed forward just a little. But anyways, you would go down here to add a game. So go to add a non-Steam game. This is the same thing as doing the right click and add that we just did. We'll go to browse. We're going to want to go to home deck. Then we'll be able to go to our download folder where we downloaded that install file that we added to Steam already. So I'll go to downloads and then go to all files here, and you'll see it pop up right here. I would be able to just click on that or open that, and then I would click add selected programs. But we're not going to do that because we've already added that, and I won't show that again in this video. But for those of you used to that method, same thing. Now we go over here into our settings and properties. And you'll see here we have compatibility. I'm going to go ahead and change this over. You could use a GE Proton layer if you prefer, or experimental. I'm going to go ahead and use experimental for this. We'll close this out. And now we're ready to go ahead and hit play and start the install. This is really just going to install the launcher that's actually going to install the game. So we'll go ahead and get that fired up here. And now we'll be able to click on here and we'll go to install. And then that'll fire off and you'll be good to go. Now, once this happens, you'll get the Microsoft Visual C Plus pop up. Click agree if that happens. Install. Only takes a couple of seconds, and you'll be good to go there. And then once that's finished, you'll be able to click run. Now, you're not running the game yet. You're just running the launcher to still install the game. So we click run now. And now we're going to have our launcher up here where we can then click get game. And that's going to go ahead and start off our download for the actual Genshin Impact game. And depending on your connection and internet and all that is really going to vary on how long it's going to take you to download this, but it could take a little bit of time. Now, while you're waiting, you could do some other things like your energy saving. Make sure your deck's not going to go to sleep on you or suspend the session or turn off Wi-Fi or anything like that and mess up your download. That can happen sometimes if you forget about it and you're waiting a while. And also in the launcher itself, in settings, there's a couple of things that you can just check off if you want to. So auto launch at startup, I don't want to happen. Show pop-up when exiting game, I don't need. And then I want it to close when we close the launcher, exit out. No limit on my download. So that's basically what I like to go with here for settings on that. A couple of things you can do while you're waiting. Then once that download's done and your game's installed, we're almost done with desktop mode. Now we're going to be able to actually add the game into Steam and then move on from there. So let's go ahead and close out of this launcher. We're going to go ahead and go open up Steam here so I can see everything's going on, and then we're going to go and add the game. Now I'm not going to do the add a game through the old school way. I'm just going to open up Discover here. I'm going to go over to the three lines here and do show hidden files. Since you can see everything here on your deck, we're going to go to .steam. Then we're going to go to the Steam folder. Then we're going to go scroll down. We're going to go to Steam apps and compat data, where I'll have it in list mode so that you can see these longer numbered files at the bottom are your non-Steam games. And this one was just added today as I was working on this, so I know this is my file. I'll click on that. I'll go to PFX. I'll go to Drive C, Program Files, Genshin Impact, and then Genshin Impact Game. Once you get in there, you'll be able to find the .exe file Genshin Impact. Now I'll just right click on this just like I did for our installer before and add to Steam. I just find this a lot easier than the older way of the add a game to Steam there, but this works really well. So you'll see it pop up over there. I can see it added into Steam already. So that's going to be good to go. And we're going to go ahead and remove the installer that we're not going to be using anymore. So now here we have Genshin Impact installed. It's add to Steam, ready to go. I'm going to do one more thing before I get out of here and go back to game mode, go into change the name here. So it's easy enough to do in game mode as well, but I have my keyboard set up here with my mouse to make things easier. So I'm just going to name this Genshin Impact. And then for compatibility, make sure that I'm going ahead and doing my experimental, or you could be doing G Proton or whatever you want there. It seems to work pretty well. All right, now with that done, we're going to be able to go into game mode, add our artwork on here with Deki Loader, and then launch into the game. So let's get moved over to game mode. Now that we're back in game mode, you can see in non-Steam games, we have Genshin Impact. But before I do anything, I want to go here to Deki Loader and you see Steam Grid DB. If you don't have Deki Loader, I have a video I'll put it in the description. I'll put a link so you can go check that out. This is an easy way to change artwork. So now when I hit start, go to change artwork, and it's easy to put your capsule, wide capsule, logos, all of that in here with Deki Loader and the Steam Grid plugin there, and it works really well. So now that I get all my artwork in there, you can see here it says Genshin Impact. We've got our banner and everything looks nice and ready to go here. We'll go down into properties. You'll even see we have our icon and then in compatibility, experimental. So we're good to go. Finally ready to launch the game. Now, one other thing, gamepad with joystick trackpad is going to be the layout you want to use in game, but I do make some changes along the way because the way I'm connected here, I need my trackpad to work. So maybe some of this information will be useful for you. I've added it into the video just in case. So let's go ahead and jump into it and take a look. All right, so once you're launched into the game, it's time to sign into your account, which is fine. You hold the Steam button and you hit X, the keyboard comes up and it works great. But the way I'm set up here recording, I can't use the touch screen and I don't have my mouse hooked up. So I need to change things to be able to actually touch where it says enter password. In order to do that, I'm including this information here in case it helps anybody else out with anything. I'm going to temporarily change over to gamepad with mouse trackpad here, which is going to make it able for me to move the cursor around. I'm also going to edit that layout and go down to trackpads, where you're going to want to change your click to be on the trackpad itself. So while it works as a mouse on the right pad, I'm going to have it do the left click here. So I go to mouse, left click, and now I can just move around and click with my right trackpad. So let's back out of here and you'll see here now I can move the cursor around and then I can click where it says enter password. This also helped me at first when I get into the game, and then I'm going to switch layouts again. Again, just for my setup here since I can't use the touchscreen, and in case this helps anybody else out. So once you're into the game, you can't really move around with this layout or do anything. However, I can still access the menu and fix all that. So if you hold down the Steam button and you hit left on the D-pad, that's going to be an escape key. Once you do that, it's going to bring up the game's menu, and then I can use that trackpad that I previously showed you I set up here. I can go click on settings really easily, and then we're going to want to switch over to controller. Now, once we do that, we'll be able to use our controls here in just a second, but I need to go in and change that layout first. So I'm going to go back to gamepad with trackpad or joystick trackpad here, activate that layout, and now I can actually move around. You'll see all the buttons have changed to match controller. And that's just how things worked out for me here. Now, I also want to change the confirm and cancel. It drives me nuts to be B confirm, A cancel for me because of Xbox being used to that layout. So I changed that right away to A confirm and B cancel. Now, as far as settings go, I'm pretty much low. I'm 60 FPS, 800p FSR2 for the anti-aliasing, and then either basically off or low here for most of the settings. And with that, I can basically get a good 60 FPS depending on where I'm at. When you're transitioning from the city and so forth, you might dip down into the 40s and back up in load-in areas, or if there's a lot going on. But for the most part, just kind of traversing around and trying out the game with these settings, I was able to get close to 60 FPS most of the time, which was really nice, and no really crash problems or issues, and surprisingly it felt smooth and good to play on the Steam Deck, which sometimes when you're pulling things off through the compatibility layers and stuff isn't always the case. So it was nice to see. But anyways, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it, and I'll see you guys in the next one.